Got a little dusty, didn't it?
Yeah.
And I tried.
Labor Day weekend.
Thank you. corner and it's getting to me. Right away, boys! Right away, boys! I think five of us can move that. Or just hop over. Is that truck coming or is it parked?
No, it's parked.
Right down there. Huh?
Is the bypass down there?
Let's go. I think we go around right here.
that defender. Thank you. think we might be on some walking trails.
Yeah.
It's nobody's fault. They gonna try and man it? Out of the way, boys. Man to blame, but I know. What'd he say?
Jump.
Bullshit. Huh? Do I have to jump? Oh, the log. Okay. I thought it was like a gap. There we go.
Is it in gear? I think he's in.
Out of the way, boys. KLR's gonna live.
Somebody.
I wasn't even going fast, y'all. I promise.
Man, waiting like a hog. No,
it was the safe part. What it was is I was coming from this left side across right here. And one of the rocks gave way.
Probably hit that slick ass rock there.
Well, that, I was braking when I hit the rock. I slipped about right there.
You okay other than your nose?
My bleeding stopped. I'll just be a mouth breather all day. It slid on my leg, this boot, hey. This boot, I'm glad I wore it, or else I'd have had a broken ankle.
Hey, I want pictures of blood on the tank. That helmet, man, he knows what happened.
You don't see nothing? I don't think you put a scratch on it.
He's a little bit here.
Good. Browley's done more damage. This little plastic piece right here.
12 or 13.
Don't get mad, huh? All right, good. he's stuck. Hey, if we face this way, we can act like we just came through it. I'll throw some water on you. You get it on.
got a good woman on there.
Yeah, jacket, I like the coat.
You're right. Friday, post-trip damage report. Let's take a look and see what we got. From my first crash, it was an actual crash. Looks like we got a bunch of ripped plastic. Not too bad in there. Looks like it came off where it meets at the hinge in there. Nothing too bad. I know it's supposed to have these plates that easily come on and off when you wreck. Ice cream scoop survived. She's a little dirty. For those that were wondering, I have the Kendas. They did surprisingly good on the trip. I was pleasantly surprised. They had a lot of grip and they did not whine on the highway. Well, when I had my wreck, you'll notice one glove is light colored and nice. Other glove was my stop my nose bleeding glove. It's very stained. Down the front of my jacket, you'll see some different blood spills. Hopefully some hydrogen peroxide will get that out. The boots. Now these boots, you can see the front toe ripping out there. JB Weld in a hotel with a hairdryer to dry it fixed for the whole heel there. It held up. Notice that that top strap is loose completely. It's not even attached, but for little cheap budget Sudici boots, they did their job. I don't think they would have made it another day, but they did decent. Overall, oh yeah, my helmet too. So the visor, it's not supposed to do that. That is now, that's now, just does its own thing. I'll have to see what's up with that. I love this Odyssey helmet. It's modular and it has a visor. So I do like it, but some gashes. But it did its job, protecting my head. Chin strap I did not have tight enough. Came up and that's what broke my nose. But other than being a little stuffy, the KLR did its job. It did great. Took everything in strides. I'm super glad I put those IMS foot pegs on. It would have been very slippery crossing all that water without them. Front tires did really well. They were brand new. Please remember, this bike is 2 weeks old now. And I think I changed the oil at about 450 miles right before we did the trip. Let's see. We are at 1317. So it did almost 900 miles of, I don't think that'd be called taking it easy on it, but that's a paper plate break-in if I've ever seen one. That's how KLR should be broken in. Not babied. Kawasaki does them good.